if the Bruins want to play to a strength, it would be to attack this Dallas team, get that forecheck game going early, get pucks in behind the Dallas defense, and really get a lot of pucks in the direction of Marty Turco.
The game is on. The Bruins back in black. Chara's pass for Bergeron does not connect. Turco very active. Ryder into the corner. Ryder to spin away from Nicklas Grossman. Bergeron beats Mike Ribeiro to the puck. Puts the stop move on him. Comes back to Aaron Warren at the right point. Chara plays it on the carom. Bergeron down into the corner. Or Stefan Robidoux can't do anything with it. Axelsson into the circle. Ward seemed to have Brendan Morrow lined up. Morrow and Ward go hard into the corner. Morrow, the Dallas captain, taking over that role from McDonald. Steve Ott back to Trevor Daly. It's into Morrow's legs. Brad Richards, who sat out last night for just the 11th game missed in his entire career. He's playing in his seventh season, and he is back at it.
Yeah, you were right about Aaron Ward. He was committed to keep that forecheck alive by making body contact with Brendan Morrow, and when he did, that puck squirted behind both players and all the way through the neutral zone into the Boston end.
Petteri Nokelainen on the far side, stacking up against Steve Ott, a very hard-working guy, and Ott's shown some scoring touch this year as well. Shane Knighty rips it right back around. Knighty has filled the role. He's not going to play 20 minutes a night, but while he's been out there, rarely has anything bad happened. He has not had a minus game in his last 10. Mark Stewart down in the corner. Ott swivels it in front. Thomas makes a point-blank stop on Richards, and back comes Savard in transition. Ahead looking for Lucic, but Robidoux plays it well past Sean Avery in the center circle. Bangs it in behind Thomas.
Big-time stop by Thomas. The play happened so quickly. A little mix-up in communication between Thomas and Stewart led to that opportunity for Dallas, but it was a nice right pad save on Richards.
Robidoux, kind of an undersized defenseman, but does not shy from contact. Will do anything to help his team get in an advantageous situation. Lucic takes the bouncing puck to Savard, quickly to Kessel, kicks to the stick and tries to fire the shot, but Grossman blocks it to the end boards. And James Neal starts it out right side. P.J. Crombie also out there with Madonna. You were talking about the two youngsters, Crombie in his second season and James Neal, a rookie. Wheeler to Sturm, he scores! Marco Sturm off the schneid, and the Bruins lead.
Haven't really had the opportunity to talk about a little forward line tinkering by the Bruins coaching staff, putting Sturm with Krejci and Wheeler to start this hockey game, moving Axelsson with Bergeron and Ryder, and Blake Wheeler with nice puck protection in the corner of the rink, and Marco Sturm very wisely finding the seam in the high slot area, wasted no time with the one-timer on a perfect feed by Wheeler through the legs of Marty Turco.
You know, Brick, it's been interesting how the Bruins coaching staff saw the flat spot from Wheeler, who was so stoked for training camp to try to make the team, and then hit a little bit of a flat spot, but they've been ramping up his minutes in the last few games, and he's been playing better and better.
Well, we talked about the things that you look for in a player like that that's going to have that flatten out period after, you know, training camp and scoring a goal in his first game in the NHL, his first NHL goal. But he was still continuing to do the little things, protect the puck, not make hope plays out where you really turn the puck over, finishing checks and being in position defensively. If you do those things, then your natural talent will start to come out, you'll start to find, you know, that comfort level. You'll start to, you know, rise to the top because he deserves to be here. He's earned his spot on this team. Got a beautiful goal in the Calgary game on that one-timer on a nice rush with Savard and Lucic, and he sets up Sturm here for the first goal of the game.
Axelsson mucking for the puck along the wall. Morrow snaps a beauty of a pass onto the stick of Louis Eriksson. He goes deep against Chara, throws it on Thomas, who bobbles it for a moment and then protects his head from the on-rushing attack.
Well, one other thing that Blake Wheeler did in that game against Calgary, he set up Krejci when the score was 3-2 right after they scored that goal, and he got robbed by Kiprusoff. But his ability to protect the puck, he's a big boy, and he uses that body well. to shield the defending player, whoever it might be, whether along the boards or in the offensive zone or trying to break a puck out along the right wing boards in your own zone. Protect that puck, and as you're doing it, survey what's going on with the other four players on your team on the ice. And he saw Sturm in the seam, and he delivered a perfect pass.
Richards and Yell on the faceoff. Sean Thornton steals the cross-ice pass. This morning, Claude Julien told us Thornton with a drive and a blocker stop. Told us there's just no way he can bust up this so-called fourth line because it is playing so well. These guys have earned more ice time with their play, and there is no way he's going to start tinkering with it. Much of the frustration of Vladimir Sobotkin. Avery with great hustle to keep the puck alive in the attacking zone for Dallas. Steve Ott spun around, gets it back to the point. Trevor Daly goes indirect, and Yell just guns it out of there. And it is ruled icing. And the faceoff will come back to the Boston zone.
The other aspect of the fourth line too, Jack, and I think this can't be overlooked, is, you know, hockey is a game of mistakes, and you're going to make some mistakes, but the coaching staff has the confidence in that fourth unit because of the energy they provide, because of the physical presence, and because of the job that they've been doing. When they don't have a great shift, you can still roll them. So they have confidence in them, in the threesome that they play, you know, in themselves.
And Sean Thornton today said, hey, you know what? We can play. You know,
yeah, that's
it's simply play. Not like we're a bunch of stiffs. Like, we can go out there and play. And they have shown it. And together, they're playing about 11 minutes a game, which is way more than players in those roles often play. Ward has a little bit of trouble going cross ice, really handcuffing Chara in the skates. Lucic muscles the puck out to the neutral zone. Erickson trying to close ground, takes a whack at him. Lucic passed Niskanen down into the corner. Matt Niskanen, Virginia, Minnesota. Savard to Kessel, tries the snapshot, and it goes off glass. Chara was going all the way forward. Kessel rotating back to the point to support the defenseman, jumping up on the play.
Great patience by Savard, looking, as if he wanted to go to Chara on the far side, who was creeping in. And all Kessel has to do is continue on that little arc out that high slot. Savard delivered.
Robidoux going against Chara, fires it wide of Thomas, intentionally so, looking for a rebound to kick in front, but Thomas clamps down.
Get one of the best sports sections in the country delivered to your home every day. Sign up now for convenient Boston Globe home delivery at 50% off. Call 1-888-MY-GLOBE or go to bostonglobe.com/subscribe.
Mike Modano, six-time All-Star, to take the face-off against Patrice Bergeron. Modano fires it on a hop, and Thomas makes a save and then denies Crombie on the turnaround. Yeah, anybody worried about Mike Modano's skills eroding? Forget about it. Bouncing puck, and he gunned that. Bergeron wide but over the line. Wrist shot going well wide. Turco blocking it to the corner. And we get a hand pass rule. The faceoff will come back in the neutral zone. 13:56 to go in the first period. Marco Sturm, after seven games with no goals, has put the Bruins on top. And the entire Zicello family is here tonight. Our producer, Brian Zicello, shamelessly putting his entire family. No, it isn't. I don't know who those jokers are. But I think that was Ron Burgundy at the end. Bruins fans, text question of the night. Who was the number one star for the Bees in October? Kessel, Savard, or Thomas? 8-3-7-3-3. And text either A, B, or C. Bergeron's shot goes off Philippe Boucher's legs to the end glass. Axelson, saucer pass. Bergeron chases the bouncing puck to the corner, cycles it for Ryder. Modano jousts with Ryder, wins the puck, brings it up to James Neal. Weidman steps up to keep it in the attacking zone, but only for the moment. And Dallas takes possession back. Matt Niskanen working his way out and fires in behind Thomas. Weidman on the touch. And the stars are just a little out of sync. One more time for that text question to 8-3-7-3-3. Hit A if you think it's Phil Kessel, B if you think it's Mark Savard, C if you think it's Tim Thomas. Answers coming up in the second intermission. David Krejci wins the faceoff to Blake Wheeler, but Crombie goes right through it. Ferentz into the circle. Krejci bangs it to the boards, and Crombie bats the backhand all the way down the ice. Weidman back for the touch, and still Dallas is out of sync. 3 o'clock in the morning arrival for the Stars after losing 5-2 in Chicago last night. Dave Tippett has put together an impressive string with Dallas based on defense.
Yeah, right at the top of active coaches in terms of winning percentage, and he's a no-nonsense guy, a guy that played, he was one of those role players that had a big role, especially with his years in Hartford, and a terrific player, understands the game. And you know, this is an organization that you expect them to be in contention every year, and a lot of it has to do with their head coach.
David Krejci leads it forward for Sturm to drive, and a save by Turco. Robidoux backhands it around through the corner. Ward taps it right back down for Wheeler. Robidoux stabs at the puck. Brad Richards turns off the indirect pass to Avery. Avery decides he's going to wire it in behind Thomas. Thomas plays it right up the middle of the zone to Krejci, and the Bruins start a breakout. Sturm pulls up at the red line, trickles it on Turco, who's one of the most active goalies in the NHL. The bouncing pass goes over Yell's stick. Avery and Weidman in the corner. Weidman wins that battle. Ferentz leads out Thornton. Thornton gains the line against Richards. Boucher stacks up Thornton. Goes the line and on the loose puck. Looking for Yell in front. Great anticipation by Avery. Avery has Ferentz turned. Avery's shot. Scores! No! Light goes on. Yeah, I thought it settled in the top corner. Sean Avery with a burst of speed through the neutral zone. Beats Tim Thomas high to the stick side. And for the seventh time this year, the Bruins have had a one-goal lead and seen their opponent come back to tie.
Yeah, as this play was developing, I like what the Bruins unit, fourth unit, was doing. Thornton just chips it in deep. Nokalainen gets to it first. Yell rotates to that high slot, but Avery with a great read. Actually comes from the left wing side, Jack, to come in through the slot to steal that puck. And why does this puck go in? You got a good look at it right there. On edge, back foot snapshot. That kind of fools Thomas a little bit. Changes its direction, probably changed more in height than it did in direction. A little high, then dips down low like a hard knuckleball. And it settles just into that top corner to the right of Tim Thomas.
That's about as close as it gets, too. I mean, it's in there by about a quarter of an inch in both directions.
No, it started in the defensive zone, and that's what Dallas Stars, that's what they make their bread and butter on. They do the job defensively, and then try to turn it into offense.
Phil Kessel tries the short side, handcuffs Turco, and finally it spills out to Ribeiro, who guns the puck off the boards. Delayed penalty coming against the Bruins. Morrow across the middle for Louis Erickson. Erickson circles back. Turco's off for the extra skater. No possession yet for the Bees. Madonna patiently over to Matt Niskanen, and he picks the puck up on a skip. Madonna looking for a little bit of space. Flicks the puck past Erickson. Erickson off Madonna's skates. The extra skater on with the man advantage coming for Dallas. Ribeiro below the dot against Ward. Throws it right through the middle. Lucic grabs it. And it's a holding call against Boston.
Yeah, it's going to go on Aaron Ward. Ward trying to pinch down the right wing boards to keep the play in the offensive end. And Morrow is able to tap it by him. And as he steps by Ward, Ward makes a little contact. See if he gets that free handout. Yeah, in the eyes of the officials, the little arm contact by Aaron Ward on Morrow will lead to the holding call.
Boston penalty number 34.
Dallas went 0-for-5 on the power play last night at Chicago. It had scored 4 power play goals in its previous 3 games on 15 power play attempts. As for the Bruins, 6-for-6 on the penalty kill at Edmonton and Vancouver, but the Bees have allowed more than one power play goal, in 3 of their last 5 games. It is the one thing they most want to correct. Their work down a man. Brad Richards gets it back from Steve Ott. Blind pass from McDonald. The blast knocked down in front. Ott knocked down by Weidman. And the Bruins do what they've done so seldom, which is to make the clear on the first chance.
Yeah, that's been probably their Achilles heel lately in terms of their penalty killing. When they've had opportunities to clear their head, they haven't been strong enough on the puck. That time they were, after a good shot block as well.
Madonna cross corner and kicks back up to Sturm. Chara whacks it away from Morrow. Thomas decides he's going to grab the can of corn, and then Chara. Everybody has fun beating on Sean Avery.
Well, there's no question Chara knew exactly who this opponent was when that puck pops up in the air and Thomas has to grab it. He knows it's Avery, and Avery will do everything he can to get into goaltenders' faces. Chara with that quick look, recognizing it's Avery. And if a referee's going to allow that kind of protection for the defenseman, by all means, exercise that luxury.
Savard flicks the faceoff back with his glove. Madonna over to Robina, back to Madonna, quickly to Robina, looks for a seam, cross ice to Ribeiro, Madonna's drive, yell! Unbelievably courageous, just throwing his body down in front of that.
Paying the price, that's what penalty killing is, that's where it starts. It's commitment and the willingness to do the things that are not comfortable.
That's gonna be icing. Nope, what did they rule here? A hand pass on the way into the zone?
I thought it was offside, but...
Offside, yeah.
You know, there was a hand pass the other night in Calgary that we were a little perplexed on a wraparound on the glass by 90, but we'll get a look at the puck movement by Dallas. They really spread it out with Richards, Madonna, and Robida. They set up Madonna for the one-timer, but Stefan Yal just lays out. And not only does he block it, he locates the puck, Jack. A nice little hand pass, and the Bruins able to clear their end.
All right, Brick, tell me why the faceoff's outside the Bruins' attacking line instead of their defending line.
Well, I thought it was an offside, and that's where the pass originated from, closest to that dot, and the offside was at the offensive blue line.
Okay, thank you. Louis Erickson glides over the line. Ribeiro brings it back. Niskanen over to the right point to Boucher. He sends it low for the captain, Morrow. Ribeiro sneaking in the back door. Morrow's pass offline. Erickson recovers it. 90 attacks Morrow. The Bruins said that they needed to be more proactive. Claude Julien wanted more hunting of the puck on the penalty kill, not to be passive. Chara gets it over to Bergeron, can't clear it through the corner. Chara bangs hard on Morrow. Bergeron has space and backhands it up to the line, but not out. Boucher keeps it in. Niskanen, top of the circle. Back to Boucher out top. Erickson backing toward the half wall. We get a hooking call against Dallas.
In the pregame show, we talked about the Bruins taking penalties at the wrong times. They find themselves tied in the game after the tying goal by Dallas on the shot by Avery. And then they're guilty of the Ward pinch down penalty. That allows Dallas a little bit more momentum. But right now, Dallas guilty of the same. On the power play, good pressure, good puck movement. And then Morrow ends up in the penalty box. This is your captain, your leader. You get an idea of the frustration the Dallas Stars are going through right now.
I believe he's going to pick up an abuse of the officials. Penalty. We will sort out the laundry. The Bruins will go on a double minor power play when we return to this 1-1 game. 29 NHL cities. Sean Avery is a villain.
Well, last year during the playoffs, get a look at what Sean Avery was doing. There was no rule against doing what he's doing right here to Marty Brodeur. Not even worry about where the puck is. He's just trying to stay right in front of Marty Brodeur, face him, try to stay in his face, get him off his game, and not allow him to see the puck. And the league quickly reacted to it.
Louis Erickson on the end boards with Chara. I remember you telling me a story about a guy in minor league hockey who did that. And it was a story that usually used to draw laughs, but now that Avery did it, Louis Erickson right in front, second chance. Oh, Thomas sticks it out. That's a reflex stop by Tim Thomas on a point-blank trickling attempt. The puck rolling up on edge, and it well could have caught a top corner or part of the side of the net, but Thomas sticks it out. Kessel passes behind Axelson. Trevor Daly steers it over to Mike Ribeiro. Speaking of villains, Stewart turns toward the middle, has a little trouble on one of his edges, and on Dallas contact, there's a whistle. That means there's a penalty coming, and the signal is hooking against Sean Avery.
As Avery trying to get in on the forecheck, Shane Knighty. Just a little too much stick work when Knighty was trying to turn and get a little separation after a little dump in. Takes a look over his shoulder. There's that little curl. He's trying to pull away from Knighty. Avery reaches in with the stick parallel to the ice. Into the hands. They're going to call that just about 100% of the time. So Avery will go to the box.
Krejci, Kessel, Lucic, Ferentz, and Weidman on the power play. Madonna to take the face off the defenseman. Nicholas Grossman on one side. Grossman around to Stefan Robidas. James Neal is the other penalty killer for Dave Tippett. It's got to be driving Dave Tippett nuts that both penalties that Dallas has drawn, you could add the unsportsmanlike on top of Moro's, but both have come in the attacking zone. Krejci steering it back through the corner. Kessel dancing at the half wall, finds Weidman across the penalty killing box. Back to Ferentz. Kessel's one-timer off the heel of the stick. Grossman, the stick check on Lucic. Madonna snaps it through the corner. Ferentz takes it back at center. Now Kessel turning away from Neal. Lucic runs into Robidas' check. Kessel gets knocked down coming across the blue line. Neal tips the puck to the blue line, but Chara is there. Wrists it for Krejci, takes it to the backhand, moves it past Robidas to Kessel on the far side. He's got Weidman back at the point. Kessel dangles against Neal. Robidas, the defenseman, in Kessel's face. Kessel tries to go through Neal, and Robidas makes the 200-foot clear with about 45 seconds to go on the power play.
Looks like the way the Dallas Stars are trying to kill their penalties and be very aggressive. I think that 3-on-2 low play may be the best option for the Bruins right now, where that half-court player starts to attack and then uses the other player, depending on the unit, down low around the goal line.
Ryder picks it up in the left-wing corner against Daly. Back to Chara against Ott. Chara back to Ryder on the half wall. Has Bergeron in this circle. Bergeron's shot. Boucher goes down to a knee to block it, and Richards turns and snaps it through the neutral zone.
Still time for one more rush for this power play unit. You got to just a little over 10 seconds. Get up ice, but then have some clock awareness and know that player Avery's coming out of the penalty box.
Ryder glides over the line. Dangles, tosses it to the corner against Axelson. Back to the middle of the line to Weidman. Avery's out of the box. Weidman quickly left side to Ryder. Ferentz is one-timer into the pile. Might have been Avery on the block. Back in the slot. Ferentz to Weidman. Avery, a lot of pressure. Weidman spins away from the check. Yell batting it out of the air. Wheeler can't control. Boucher, D to D to Matt Niskanen. Niskanen, 21 years old. It rolls into the right of Thomas. B.J. Krombien after it. Krombien mucking along with Ferentz. Morrow past Weidman and Ribeiro in the final minute of the first period. Weidman into the middle of the Boston zone. Yell taps it over to Wheeler. Wheeler on the go with Axelson filling on the left side. Wheeler holds well wide on the right. Axelson into the right wing corner. Boucher gives him a bump from behind. Yell takes a poke at the puck. Axelson dives to try to make the pass. Wheeler on the bouncer. Second chance, whacks it low. 30 seconds to go, plenty of time. Wheeler steps in front. Yell shot. Oh, Turco robs it. Yell right back to the short post. Marty Turco's sixth sense save.
Add this one to the one he made on Krejci on the backhand through traffic at the tail end of a power play or in the middle of the power play. How about this one? What a great play by Blake Wheeler to stay with it. He got good help from Axels and he got good help from Yell, and they create what appears to be an empty net, but no. Again, Turco in similar fashion, diving back from left to right, left arm extended up high with the glove hand, and he's able to keep this a 1-1 game.
Petteri Nokelainen on the faceoff. Brad Richards wins it. Avery running into Sturm's traffic. 15 seconds to go in the period. Robidas lobs it to the line. Ott takes it waist high. Richards backhander looking for Avery. Thomas helps bunt it out. 2 seconds to go. Nokelainen to the red line. Goes cross ice with a bit of clock management. Ott finishes his check at the siren. And then Ward comes in and gives a shot to Avery. Now Ott and Stewart have a verbal meeting at the red line.
I really like this response by the Bruins because every player on the ice was aware of how much time was left in the period when Nokelainen was just trying to get up to the red line, maybe even get a shot on goal from long distance. And Ott came and finished his hit. And the Bruins players, teammates, all move in. Stewart responds, Ward responds. Ott has a reputation, and you do not let that pass without responding to it. The Bruins did just that.
Bruins trying to reestablish themselves as a team that puts opponents in the torture chamber when they come visiting. So Gager votes in. Marco Sturm ends a seven-game streak without having scored a goal, putting the Bruins on top at 2:41, and then Sean Avery with an end-over-ender that just barely caught the upper corner and nestled in the net. And then they left it to the magic of Marty Turco from there on out. Turco robbing Stefan Yell with a highlight of the week type save.
Yeah, we had to certainly give him his props for those two unbelievable stops he made on Krejci and Yell. But, you know, at the opposite end of the ice, Tim Thomas, maybe not as dynamic, but pretty efficient in that first period, Jack. He robbed Richards early on in tight. Of course, the two shorthanded bids, Peterson and Ott from the tops of the circles on opposite sides of the ice. Erickson had one right from the top of the crease. Looked like he got the fat part of the stick on the puck when it was in midair. Modano had a pretty good chance, too, when he swept a little quick wrist shot through traffic. So Thomas Sharp again here tonight as well.
Off the faceoff, Ribeiro wins it back. Nicholas Grossman, 23-year-old defenseman from Stockholm. Moro taps it in behind Thomas. He lets it go. Chara one-hands it past Erickson up to Axelsson. Axelsson has Ryder ahead and Bergeron on the far side. Cross-corner dump. Grossman against Bergeron. Grossman puts the body between his man and the puck. Up the wall, but Axelsson intercepts. Centering pass beyond Bergeron's reach. Moro. Bergeron battles hard for the puck. That's exactly what Claude Julien wants to see out of the forward.
And Axelsson really had a good look. He had Bergeron rotating to that slot area. They just missed connecting.
Chara has a little trouble on the clear out. Only gets it to the paint. Ott keeps it in. Yell calms things down and flicks it through center. Then there's a big collision right in front of the Dallas door.
I don't know if that was a clean hit by Ott or not, but Thornton didn't think so.
Thornton and Ott. Thornton bangs him with the right. Him down. They're gonna call off the fight.
The Bruins may end up shorthanded here, Jack, but Thornton's response to this, at first blush, it looked like Ott went at Stefan Yell a little low. It definitely got the attention of Sean Thornton in the neutral zone. You get a look at it. Yell's just gonna clear this puck up.
Oh.
Stand up, go shoulder to shoulder in that instance. That's not a clean hit. Remember, Ott delivered a hit on Nokalainen at the end of the first period, and we talked about it. The response by the Bruins, no love lost there with that player in white, number 29, and the Bruins, Sean Thornton, responding to that low hit on Yell by Ott. You know, there are good things. I mean, there are hip checks still that still exist in the National Hockey League that are good hip checks. In my opinion, this is not one of them. He has a chance to step right into Yell and go shoulder to shoulder. Instead, he goes low. And Yell really in a defenseless situation. There's a lot of talks about hits to the head. Before they cleaned up the hits to the head or in the process of doing so, they wanted to take care of the low hits. I'm not a fan of that check by Steve Ott.
I think the head position is the giveaway. Hunting for a joint. 4 minutes posted against Sean Thornton. I have yet to hear a call. So the Bruins have a potential momentum swinger here in this penalty kill. And there is Steve Ott, brings it back to Romanov. Fires it across to Modano, back to Romanov, middle of the line. Richards is a sniper of the shot. Saved by Thomas, getting square to the shot. And Ott gets right in Thomas's face.
Quick puck movement out high, and they set up Richards for the one-timer. This is not uncharted waters for Brad Richards. Great in the playoffs, the year Tampa won the Stanley Cup, ran a lot of power plays, even though he's a forward, very good out high, much like a Savard, who has a real good shot and doesn't hesitate to use it.
4 minutes in minor penalties for roughing to Sean Thornton. Madonna with a blast that's well wide. Richards calms down the rebound. Robidoux's one-timer. Ferenc gets the stick on it. And a penalty coming here as Weidman makes the clear. Steve Ott.
29 Dallas.
We'll hear it.
Yeah, good shot blocked by the Bruins defense. Andrew Ferenc stands in strong, blocks it with his stick, and Weidman's in good proximity to jump on that loose puck. As he tries to move that puck the length of the ice, the stick work by Ott from behind. The Bruins were facing a four-minute power play for the Stars, much like the Bruins had 4 minutes of power play opportunity back-to-back in the first period with the penalties tomorrow. They get a good break here.
So it's 4-on-4. Ryder in the corner now. Morrow chugs up. Aaron Ward's the defenseman facing him. Morrow climbs out of line, but the pass back to the line deflects it. Here comes Ryder with a steam of speed. Ryder shot. Saved by Turco. Bergeron steals and scores! Replay of Calgary. Patrice Bergeron makes it 2-1.
Play goal in the sense that he was able to steal a puck behind the net, step right out and score, but this time it was the steal of the defenseman. Ryder jumps on that deflected pass in the neutral zone. Not a good decision by Morrow to try to make a play where he did, given the fact they were playing 4-on-4. Ryder tries to hunt the puck down, but it was Bergeron very cleverly using the stick and right skate to stay in the passing lane. The great steal and the presence of mind to know that Turco was expecting that puck perhaps to come out over his left shoulder and didn't have time to react and get tight to that near post, and Bergeron took advantage.
Claude Julien talks about being strong on the stick, being strong on the puck. Now, usually he's talking about the penalty kill, but there was an example from Bergeron. Here's Kessel flying up and forcing Turco to have to take a faceoff in his own zone.
One more look at the goal after the shot by Ryder at the top of the circle. You got Daly behind the net. And it was Morrow that tried to get back and held out after the turnover in the neutral zone. But it's Bergeron working all three zones, plays in every situation. Here we are 4-on-4. He makes the steal up ice. And just his hockey IQ, he knows he has an opportunity to beat Turco short side, and he does it.
Kessel's drive and a stop by Turco. Ferenc wrists it low. It is the first 4-on-4 goal the Bruins have scored this season. Savard swings it in front, trying to find Kessel. Erickson pulls up in front of the Boston bench with Weidman lining him up for a check.
Two nice plays by Savard. It started with a faceoff win cleanly in the offensive zone, led for the chance for Kessel, and then that play on his backhand.
Boucher over the line and an easy stop for Thomas. He spills it out for Dennis Weidman. Chips up the boards for Nokalainen. Savard gets a piece to the bouncing puck. 45 seconds left in Ott's penalty, and then it'll be about a minute and 25 on the power play for Dallas. Daly at the hash marks. Weidman bumps him. Richards in the corner. All the way around to Boucher. Boucher past Avery. Richards. Ferenc has an eye on Avery going to the net. Avery steps into the crease. Centering pass. Weidman turns it up ice. He's got Nokalainen left. He's got Ryder filling on the right. The diagonal dump in. Turco will play it. He chips it over to Avery. Avery tries to sneak it through to Madonna, who's fresh off the bench. Turco wheels it off glass. Krejci gets there first for Boston. It deflects back to center. Ott's on his feet. And Dallas is now on the power plays. Madonna gains the zone. Goes into the middle. Sturm chips it to the boards. Krejci follows hard. Can't clear it. Chara has it scooped through his legs. Ott really unloads on Chara, who throws Ott down, but he makes the play from his knees. Back to Niskanen. The one-timer, Robidoux. Thomas lunging across. Niskanen's wrist shot with Avery in front. Thomas throws it to the corner. Ott turns it out of the corner. Madonna with the hash marks. Cross ice, Robidoux's blast. Glove save, Thomas. And Chara just tosses Ott down like a piece of meat.
And Ott wants a penalty, if you can believe it. Chara protecting the front of the net, wins the battle of strength. You know, there's no penalty call for a questionable hit in the neutral zone, and he wants a penalty just because Jarrett throws him to the ice. Thomas, good concentration. He got a good look at it. The penalty kill is doing enough to allow that shooting lane. If you can't get in the shooting lane, make sure you turn, pivot, try to box people out in order to let your goaltender see the puck.
Robina at the hash marks, throws it right through the middle. Ribeiro circles below the goal line. Has Robina at the right point. Robina back to Ribeiro, top of the circle. Morrow along the goal line. Weidman doesn't give him any space. Morrow loses an edge. Weidman battles for the puck. Bergeron over to try to dig it out. Comes off Erickson. Bounces into the slot. Ferentz backs up, takes his time, winds and rips it the length of the ring. Stefan Robidoux gains the line, the wrist shot, glove save. Thomas, he'll have to take the faceoff as Robidoux goes right through. Well, villains can be good for the hockey fan because they clearly wear the black hat, and there's no doubt that Dallas has ridden into town willing to play that role tonight.
Well, for the most part, in most instances, players would tell you that they love to have players like that on your team. It's not 100% the case, but for the most part, and Avery had a positive influence on the Rangers a year ago. The question is, can he have that same positive influence here for the Dallas Stars when they already have a guy like Steve Ott?
Stewart bangs Ott. That takes possession away from him. Shane Knighty steps up and gets the puck forward to Savard. And the Bruins back to full strength. Ott unloads, both skates off the ice, and on they play. And here we go. Knighty squares off against Ott.
Ott will fight him.
And credit to the officials, the arms remain down. Well, they know what's going on here.
Well, there was a breakdown of communication because Ferentz went back. I believe it was Ferentz that went back, Jack, to touch that puck up as if it was an icing. And there was no icing call. And to Ott's credit, he finished the hit. He played to the whistle. There was no whistle. But did he stay skates on the ice was one question. Third questionable hit by Ott. And Knighty was responding. And Ott wouldn't fight him. And then later, up ice on the same shift, you had Thornton and Avery exchanging words right in front of the Bruin bench. It's Stewart that went back on the touch.
Ott's going to the box. Knighty's going to the box. Avery has 1 foot in the box. I believe Lucic is already in there.
Don't you get the sense that this is going to be all even when it's all said and done?
One would think so.
You know, as players, Jack, especially the tougher guys, you know, the beauty of hockey is, and certainly in the day, the players policed the game. Certainly if the officials weren't, they weren't going to make the calls. I'm not talking about the ticky-tack, little holding and hooking calls. I'm talking about the physical and the questionable and the on-edge hits. And the players take it upon themselves to police the game.
Well, Milan Lucic is not going to let anybody come into this house and take shots at his teammates. All four currently in the box got 2 minutes each for unsportsmanlike conduct, so there will be no manpower change. Five skating against five in front of the goalies, although I only see four Bruins out there right now. Now Nokalainen swings his legs over the boards.
Well, you know there's going to be a spotlight on Ott Avery for the rest of the game, so if you're a Bruin player and you want to settle some scores, just do it as best you can within the rule.
Savard whips the pass to Weidman. The backup drive tipped in front. Oh, Turco, another acrobatic save. Tumbling backward. Boucher lays a couple of big hits on Kessel up high. Well, we got a rodeo going here tonight. There's no doubt about it. Nokalainen. Boucher bangs him. Ferentz whips a hard pass into Weidman's skates. He handles it nicely with the soft hands. Savard gives it up. Fistrick on the ice. We didn't see a whole lot of him in the first period.
One shift.
Ferentz backs it up to Weidman. Madonna the front man. Weidman trying to spin against one of the still speediest guys in the game. Boucher takes it away from Nokalainen. Nokalainen throws the shoulder into James Neal and he bounces off. Robitaille will have to collect it behind his own goal. The Bruins with a quick full five-man shift. Robitaille going diagonally against Sturm. Thomas reverses. Ward can't clear the zone. The wrist shot saved by Thomas as he stops Peterson from long range. And Ward with a big hit on Peterson in the corner. Here comes Wheeler. Wheeler tries to turn inside against Grossman. The backhand drifts into the slot. Stewart jumping up. But now here comes Brunstrom, the rookie on the off wing. Brunstrom shot. Saved Thomas loose in the crease. Thomas gets pounded back into the goal. And James Neal gains the attention of the officials.
It should be Neal going to the box.
13:09 left to play in the second period. It is really rough and tumble at the Garden tonight. Steve Ott got it going, and he's on the receiving end of a lot of it.
Two-one Bruins lead the Stars. Discipline comes in a number of forms. It's not just staying out of the penalty box. It's making good decisions and having good communication. Lucic thinks he has an opportunity to try a one-on-one move, but here's the problem. Guys are making a line change on the back end. Both Ward and Chara going to the Bruin bench, thinking the Bruins have puck possession going into the zone. The Bruins forwards are going to keep it deep, and because they don't, a quick counterattack by Dallas forces Thomas to make a timely left shoulder save.
Weidman slap shot shatters Avery's stick. Richards gains the line. Stewart bangs him against the boards. Richards strong on his skates. Thornton bumps Ott. The puck comes loose. Weidman leaves it behind. Gathers it up. Ott attacks him with a good hard stick check. Avery back of the goal. Richards tries the wraparound off the back of the goal. Ott holds his ground. Robitaille's shot tipped in front. Saved by Thomas. Avery going to the front to make traffic. Nokalainen and a big hit on Avery. Centering pass Richards. It's into the skates of Yell. Ott turns around and gives a two-hander to Yell right across the back. Nicholas Grossman gliding toward his own line. Fires it all the way in on Thomas, trying to hit Peterson on the way through. Weidman scoops it to the corner. Peterson attacking on the forecheck. Ferentz gloves it, and it goes up into the protective netting.
Yeah, they might be calling
it. And that's going to be a delay of game penalty.
Well, TD Bank North and the Boston Bruins would like to welcome members of the Bridge of Massachusetts as the TD Bank North Kids Clubhouse guest for tonight's game. TD Bank North going above and beyond for kids in all of our communities.
Well, if you cause the puck to leave the playing surface directly from inside your blue line, it's a delay of game penalty.
And even though Andrew Ferentz doesn't do it by shooting the puck up over the glass, because he gloves it with his hand, the officials are going to call this delay a game. He's just trying to react to that puck so it doesn't get left of him into that slot area where it's obviously dangerous.
That's his best intentions, reflexes working out badly. So the Bruins have another penalty to kill. Louis Erickson setting up in the half wall. Mike Ribeiro goes right to goal, and Thomas holds the post on him. And Morrow takes an extra shot. Now he pops Char, and Char is going to retaliate. Well, at what point do you ask the referees nicely to stop your opponent from coming into the crease after the whistle with impunity and taking an extra shot?
Well, that's what I was. That was what I was getting at with this whole, you know, concept of policing the game. If you're the players, if you're the officials, you allow the players to police the game, then allow them to do it. Especially in these areas where you're trying to protect the front of your net, protect your goaltender. Morrow's got his stick in there. You got the scrums going on. If you're not going to call penalties, then don't call penalties.
Philippe Boucher at the right point comes up to the half wall. Erickson lets it go to Ribeiro in the corner. Chara with emphasis. A check on Ribeiro. Savard walks it out to center and then loops it into the right wing corner. Minute 35 to go on Ferentz's delay penalty. Madonna winds it up. Finds Boucher on the tape. Axelson with a perfect hip check to stop him. Chara makes the 200-foot clear off glass. Madonna turns it high in his zone, thanks to Turco playing the puck. Ribeiro dangles. Ward with a poke check, and Bergeron, the short little wristy sand wedge to get it to the green. Halfway through the penalty kill, Ribeiro stick handles into traffic. Morrow through Erickson's skates. 90. A little flip over to Weidman. Weidman up to the point. Boucher keeps it in the zone. Weidman gloves it down into the corner. Morrow goes head over tea kettle, and they are going to call Weidman for a slash. Axelson going toward the box.
No, Weidman.
No, he's just
right.
Protesting it. Weidman goes for a slash. So 45 seconds of 5-on-3.
Well, we talk about the players controlling their emotions. We'll try to do the same up here. When you disagree with what you're watching, two-handed chop, I guess, by Dennis Weidman is going to send him to the box. It's difficult when you watch some of these questionable hits and then you see a little slash by Dennis Weidman that's going to send him to the box and create a 5-on-3 that can truly have a major impact on the result of this hockey game. And that's the frustrating part when you watch this. But the Bruins gonna have to dig deep, stay focused, manage this 5-on-3 as best they can. They do have the luxury of having a one-goal lead at this point in the hockey game. So the 5-on-3 obviously now becoming critical. But let's go back a little bit, Jack. The Bruins had possession of the puck in their own zone. From behind the net, Weidman had a chance to step out and rip one hard off the glass or go up the middle hard. He went off the glass, but it wasn't hard enough, and Boucher, I believe it was able to keep the play in the offensive zone, and that leads to another penalty.
Dallas calling the timeout. Dallas has one 5-on-3 goal this season. The Bruins have yet to allow a 5-on-3 goal to be scored. Off the faceoff, there is a loose stick. It is Savard's. It is not broken. Madonna to Robidoux. They go high-low now. Richards right across the crease with Morrow looking for the tip. Ribeiro in the corner back to Madonna. Madonna risks it over to Richards. Robidoux tees it up. Didn't get anything on it, and Savard scoots it down the rink. 20 seconds to go on Ferentz's penalty before it becomes 5-on-4.
And you got to keep making quick changes because Turco will turn that puck up quickly.
Ribeiro holds. Madonna with Robidoux on the right. Richards is down in the circle. They go crisscross. Now it's Ribeiro. Robidoux. Ribeiro below the goal line. Chips it over Chara's stick. Richards at the dot. Good stick position. Axelson knocks it out of the middle. Ferentz is back on the ice. The Bruins with three defensemen and Axelson out there right now trying to kill this penalty off. As Ferentz deflects it past Robidoux's point a minute ago on Weidman's penalty. Chara going in deep, beats Richards to the puck. Ward tries to staple Ribeiro into the end wall. Chara comes over to help out with Morrow stabbing at the puck to try to get it loose for Dallas. Chara caves in Ribeiro. Ward kicking it along the yellow kick plate just to try to keep the clock running. About 35 seconds to go on the power play. Madonna has to settle the puck as it hops over his blade. Chara turns it out of the corner. Ribeiro against Axelson. Chara turns and scales it the length of the rink with 25 seconds to go.
Huge play by Axelson. Stayed with it, turned back down the boards and went through Ribeiro hard to get it back to Chara.
Yell and Bergeron, the penalty killing forwards. 90 and Ferentz to try to finish off this penalty kill for Boston. Trevor Daly. Steve Ott on the half wall. Final minute of the second period. Daly. A drive and a save by Thomas. Niskanen getting all of it on a one-timer. 1 second to go on Weidman's penalty kill. 55.5 to go in the period and a potential big emotional swing here.
Well, everybody's focusing on the Bruins penalty killing and how much it needs to improve, and you hope situations like this go a long way to building the confidence of the penalty killing units. A 5-on-3 for a lengthy period of time, and the Bruins, with just 1 second to go in this situation, have done a terrific job killing this 5-on-3 at a critical point in the hockey game.
Ott wins the faceoff. Daly's shot saved by Thomas. The penalty expires. It's 5-on-5 with 52 seconds to go. The Bruins have had a parade to the penalty box in the second period.
Well, some examples of this penalty killing by Boston. Char with a good read, and even though that wrapper on the glass doesn't get to the intended target, the heads-up play by Axelsson. You talk about being aggressive when it's the right time to be aggressive. That's exactly what Axelsson was able to do and get it back to Char for that nice high lob out of the zone.
Toby Peterson, perhaps with an equipment problem.
Yeah, it has to be, or some kind of physical problem. Otherwise, he needs to stay on the ice.
Richards gets thrown out. Krejci against Steve Ott on the faceoff. Oh, it squeaks through Thomas and goes all the way through, and Avery gives Thomas an extra pop while he's getting up. Boucher's wrist shot. Avery looking for the deflection. Kessel hustles over and wins the puck at the boards, but again gives it away to Daly. 90 in the final 35 seconds of the period. Lucic breaks it out. He's got Krejci ahead of him. Now Ferentz jumping up on the play against Boucher. The wrist shot. Save. Rebound. Bounces over Kessel's stick. 90. Back to the goal. Kessel. Past Krejci. 90 tries to tip it into the middle for Lucic. 15 seconds to go. Plenty of time on this rush. Here comes Richard. Saucer pass looking for Ott. Richard's second chance turnaround shot saved by Thomas. And Ferentz steps hard into Ott, who is looking for that after the whistle shot on the Boston goalie.
Well, a little tough luck for Phil Kessel. He had that rebound opportunity after the Bruins got up ice with Ferentz joining the rush. Hopped over his stick, and then 91 to keep the play alive in the final minute here, the second period. Tried to make a little chip pass into the slot area. That didn't work, and it nearly led to a 2-on-1. But Kessel circles the net, Jack, and he gets all the way back to put enough pressure on the puck carrier to nullify the 2-on-1. And then the shot on goal leads to a little extracurricular with you-know-who.
Yeah, Ott and Avery, of course, giving the reach-around face wash to Ferentz. Bergeron wins the faceoff straight back in the final 10 seconds. Bruins just need to make the safe play and run out the second period clock here. And they survive a period in which they were often shorthanded. Tim Thomas with some excellent saves under pressure. They fight off a 5-on-3 situation and they go to the room leading the Stars 2-1.
A lot of shots for Tim Thomas in period number two, somewhere in the 20 neighborhood. 21 to be exact. So he was the Bruins' best player in that period. But I like the way the Bruins responded as a team when things started to get a little nasty on the ice. That builds a lot of unity. They got a ton of it already, but it continues to build what you need, especially early in the season, especially at home.
Change.
Season like no other came to a tragic end.
Scott Walker, the villain, breaks Boston's heart.
And the team that took it all away is back. Bad blood stems from the 2009 postseason, and the Bruins are ready for a grudge match with their nemesis from Carolina. Saturday is New England Hockey Night with Hurricanes Bruins coverage beginning at 6:30 on NESN.
Boston Bruins Hockey on NESN is brought to you by Southwest Airlines and by Subaru. Bruins goals tonight by Marco Sturm and Patrice Bergeron, sandwiching a Sean Avery goal. A very emotional second period. We asked you earlier this evening who you thought the Bruins' number one star in October was, and had you text your answers to 83733. And the winner, drum roll please, Tim Thomas. And who could argue with that? Thomas tonight has made 30 saves already, and he's got 20 minutes to go. And the ninth floor, which houses the media, was really a buzz between periods, Brick. And somewhat fitting that on this date in 1924, Charles Adams was awarded the first U.S.-based NHL team. And the contest to name the club ended up being a nice alliteration, the Boston Bruins. There's the current management, Jim Benning on the right, Cam Neely in the middle, and Peter Chiarelli, who's walking toward the back of that booth. But rather active discussion between periods.
Yeah, I was certainly involved in several myself, Jack, as to, talking about the tougher players. And for example, the guys on the Bruins, guys like Chara and Thornton and Lucic, I'll even throw Aaron Ward into that mix. Trying to contain your emotions and your frustration, I guess, is the better word. When you got guys like Ott and Avery getting under your skin, and you can't do enough to settle the scores on some of the questionable hits that you think are questionable. And all that being said, keeping in mind that this is all about winning a hockey game first and foremost.
And right off the faceoff, Ribeiro goes in, low bridges Chara, trying to back into his knees right in front of the Boston bench.
Well, Chara's just trying to get to that red line, and Ribeiro's just trying to cut off his lane. That's okay.
I like the way he faced him, though.
That's okay. Not much there. You know, Guy Lafleur once said, and I read this somewhere, I can't remember where it was, but I took note of it. He said, I never put myself in situations that I can't win.
Well, that was one for Mike Ribeiro, the ex-Canadian. Stefan Robidoux can't get it past Axis, and Axis has had a couple of great examples of stick position tonight. Ryder spins around Ribeiro back of the goal. Robidoux out to Morrow, slips the pass to Ribeiro. He works against Ward. Ribeiro pulls up, throws it into the pile. It trickles through Ward's skates. Chara with the clear, and it bounces over Grossman's stick. Ribeiro off the legs of Axelsson. Ward off the end boards for Chara. Louis Eriksson, the forechecker. Bruins will change it up. Avery goes one-on-one against Ward. The shot, nice save by Thomas. Dragging the left pad out. Avery cross ice. Boucher has a little bit of space, throws it on Thomas high, and he makes the glove stop.
Pretty good old-fashioned wrist shot by Sean Avery, stepping into the offensive zone. Right around the tops of the circles, try to use the Bruins' defense. Aaron Ward has a screen and rip it right through him. He does. Thomas has to make a pretty good left pad stop.
It's good to have villains. Makes the game interesting. Boucher, no collide, and breaks him up. Yell to Thornton, the wrist shot, and a save by Turco. And Daly and Yell have a confrontation. Thornton making sure he's in the neighborhood in case something untoward might happen.
A pretty good play by the fourth unit. Nokelainen getting out to his point man to block the shot. Allowed Yell, Thornton, and Nokelainen to get up ice, get into the offensive zone, put a shot on goal, and get a faceoff in the offensive end.
Savard with Lucic left and Kessel right. Madonna wins the faceoff cleanly back to Boucher. Boucher up the middle for Madonna. Into the skates of James Neal. He tosses it down into the corner. Ferentz after it. Crombeen finishes his check on Ferentz. Weidman off the legs of Lucic. Boucher gives chase. Savard with a little bump. Lucic pops the puck in the air. Madonna loses his stick. Lucic keeps it inside the zone. It's 3-on-2. Savard recovers his edges, and Kessel goes to work on the end boards against Boucher. Lucic with the steal, takes it away from Madonna. Diagonal for Ferentz. It dribbles off his stick. Crombeen hits Ferentz up high. Kessel cycles high, rotates, throws it in front. Lucic, the short shot saved by Turco. And Boucher knocks down Savard. Crombeen chops the puck past the blue line. The trailing linesman's hand is in the air. Weidman on the touch. It's icing against Dallas.
Tonight, following Bruins overtime live, it's Sports Desk, presented by FW Webb, home of Frank Webb's Bath Centers. In addition to extended Bruins coverage, they'll check in on the Celtics in Indianapolis and let you know how the BC Eagles fared against Clemson. That's Sports Desk tonight, following Bruins overtime live.
The 21 shots on goal by Dallas in the second period were a season high for the Stars and for the Bruins against. Sturm's dribbler goes wide on the glove side. Wheeler shovels it low. Krejci handles it nicely with the skate. Sturm tries to wrap around off. Wheeler skates in front. Stewart plays it nicely with the glove. Knighty wrists it toward the pile. It hits Wheeler, comes back out. Neal guns it off the boards. It'll drift in wide right of Thomas for another icing call against Dallas. So the third period has started a little bit the way the first period started, with Dallas drawing several icing calls against it.
Well, this is back-to-back icings with the same unit on the ice, so no line change, a lengthy shift for Dallas. The Bruins able to roll the fresh line on the ice and be well served to try and keep this puck in the offensive end. But if it does come out, counterattack quickly.
Well, Madonna won the faceoff. Shane Knighty. Axelson on the tape. Morrow stick check, wins it away. Louis Erickson with a hop in his step, save. Thomas trickles out the back, wrap around. Oh, a saving play by Bergeron as he comes back and denies the open goal. Patrice Bergeron keeps it a one-goal Boston lead. Well, that is star of the game type stuff from Patrice Bergeron. Big plays around the net in both directions, both at the same end. Ribeiro dangling against Axelson. Axelson plays the body. Ribeiro keeps maintaining the puck. Ribeiro tries to wedge away from Knighty. Knighty on his knees, but Morrow intercepts. Thomas scoops it up after making the save. And Tim Thomas is one more save away from tying a season high.
Well, once the Dallas Stars are able to make a line change, get the Madonna line off the ice, the Ribeiro line on, Erickson, who's got a hot stick right now, four goals in four recent games. He has that initial shot that Thomas handles, but he has that presence of mind to stay with it. And he feels like he can beat Thomas to the opposite side of the net with a quick wraparound as the Bruins all converge to that slot area with Bergeron. They really got into that wraparound shooting lane.
And Michael Ryder also on the back check, getting a piece of the bouncing puck. Lucic into the skates of Kessel. It kicks back into the Boston zone. Toby Peterson whiffs on it for a moment. Fistrick off the boards. Fistrick and Lucic were teammates on the Vancouver Giants in the WHL for a year. Savard back in the passing lane, tosses it across the defensive zone. Kessel wants to regroup, and he taps it back for Weidman. Hard pursuit from Chris Barch. Savard inside out, and he handles it beautifully, then goes cross ice. Kessel with Lucci busts in the middle of the shot. Scores! Insurance! 3-1 Boston! What a play by Savard in his own end.
And that is what is required of complete players. Savard was able to get into a passing lane, and by doing so, it leads to a breakout. He knows he can just throw it across the ice in the direction of Kessel, and Kessel's speed, it just backs defensemen off. And when he's able to get Fistrick in by the faceoff dot, because he backed in so far, that allows him that little curl and drag. It changes the direction or the angle of the shot ever so slightly to force the goaltender to have to reset. When you do, when you have a quick release like Kessel, quick and accurate, right through Turco.
Avery crisscrossing with Ott. The wrist shot going wide, but Thomas makes the glove stop. Kessel gets his team leading seventh of the season after going five games without a point. But you know what? It's not about the points this year for Phil Kessel. He has become a three-zone player.
Well, that whole process of maturing as a player continues. Let's not forget how young this player is. Relatively inexperienced when you talk about the National Hockey League, and he just continues to get better as he learns more and more how to play this game and play more like a complete player.
Thornton and Ott are jousting in the high slot. Avery, Todd, oh, a hit! Ferentz flattens Ott. Boucher's drive, Weidman blocks it down. Ott's gonna unload on Nokalainen and hammers him in the corner. He's gonna get the penalty, and now they're gonna go. Ferentz banging Avery. Avery takes a shot at him on the way down. Ferentz wants more. He wants to rip that guy limb from limb. And who wouldn't want to see that? You bet.
Well, that's how you respond. What did we say? Pick your spots. What a great read by Ferentz. Within the rules, body contact in the open ice. Always, always enjoyable to watch in a game of hockey. And the thing I like best, Avery challenges Ferentz, and he drops the glove. He's willing. I'll answer the bell. It might be the only opportunity tonight any Bruin will have a chance to drop gloves with Avery, because there have been opportunities to this point in the hockey game, and it hasn't happened. Fun, isn't it?
Unanimous decision, Ferentz over Avery. Four good hard jabs before Ferentz went down.
It's a great open ice hit by Andrew Ferentz.
Oh.
And on the right guy.
Ott gets the extra penalty. At 4:54, Boston on the power play.
There's only one way to finish this sequence off with a power play goal.
Chara, the drive and a save by Turco with Ryder looking for a rebound. Look at this hit. This is beautiful.
It's open ice. It's a perfect angle. It's not early. It's not late. It's not illegal.
And you know what? If there is a mandatory penalty for a hit to the head, Ferentz would go to the box for that, and that would really, really damage this game. Chara, Savard into the slot, it bounces around. Madonna from Daly, and he clears. Ryder steps over the line, works Robidas' corner. Sturm nudges it back to Chara. Bergeron at the right point. Ryder on the half wall. Goes low for Sturm. Savard in the right wing corner. Bergeron around the perimeter. Chara sneaking in the back door. Savard cradling the puck. Low. Sturm tries to turn it middle, and a good stick check from Robidas, who's had a very good game for Dallas tonight.
Yeah, he's a good player, underrated across the league, but the Darryl Stars organization know how important he is to their success.
Milan Lucic gets a little bit ahead of the puck, and it's offside. You know, we haven't even mentioned that Sergei Zubov is on the shelf for Dallas with hip surgery. Yuri Lehtinen is not appearing in this game. Joel Lundqvist just went down with a shoulder injury a week ago. He's out another 4 or 5 weeks. You know, last night with Turco out and Richards not playing, they had about $24 million of payroll not playing in the game against Chicago.
I'll take that one step further, because in the open we said this is not the Dallas Stars of last year. Antti Miettinen, real important player to Dallas last year. He leaves via free agency, as does Hagman, who's up in Toronto now. He's a 27-goal man last year.
Yep. Lucic goes around Boucher. Lucic still has it, brings it back. Axelsson rotating, the one-timer from Weidman goes off the heel of the stick. Krejci in the corner, nudges it back to Weidman, he chucks it off the boards. Ribeiro gets in the way of Krejci's pass, takes a swipe. Weidman battles Morrow. Morrow tips Weidman over, the puck's underneath. Krejci trying to dig it out of Morrow's skates. And Morrow knocks it back into his own zone. Boucher can't clear, Lucic lugs it into the slot, the drop pass for Krejci. Good back check by Morrow, but the puck's still loose. Lucic comes through and cleans it out to the corner. Ribeiro drags it forward. Ott's out of the box. Kessel trying to get around Turco. Turco's going for an interference penalty. And there's Ott trying to low bridge Lucic 2 seconds after the whistle. And the cheap shots continue from Steve Ott. Whose career is going to end when that guy gets away with something like that? He's a knee-seeking missile. He's a scud.
Four Bruins over the Stars, just under 13 minutes to go here in the third period, and even Marty Turco is going to get in on this parade to the penalty box. Little interference with Phil Kessel riding that left arm up high and then in the neutral zone. The extracurricular continues. Steve Ott right in the middle of it. Again, kind of inching low on his body contact, that time with Lucic.
Last spring, the Dallas Stars beat Anaheim in six, eliminated Joe Thornton in San Jose in six, and then forced Detroit to six games before succumbing in the conference final. This year, Dallas comes into this game 4-5-2, 8 points off San Jose's lead in the Pacific already.
And after that certain level of success in the postseason, Jack, after 3 years in a row where they went out in the first round, maybe there was a sense of entitlement by this Dallas Stars team, but they got a lot of new faces. They're gonna have to earn that kind of respect.
Stern turns across the crease. Little pinball as Bergeron was sneaking in the back door. Sturm holds. Savard. Sturm off the goal line. He rotates. Now he comes off the boards, creating all this. Slipped it in front. Ryder steers it back to Chara. Boy, when a guy comes off the boards like that in that short arc you love, Brick, it just changes the whole dynamic. Bergeron. Chara's one-timer saved by Toko.
Yeah, you know I'm a proponent of that kind of attack on the man advantage when you have a team that's very aggressive in the penalty kill, and that's what Dallas has been tonight. So when that player on the half wall has the puck, whether it's Sturm or Savard on the opposite side of the ice, maybe it's Krejci, maybe it's Kessel, if you arc and start to attack the defensive formation of the penalty killers, it creates that two-on-one on the sideboards, and it creates that two-on-one down low. The Bruins had a couple of looks at it.
Bergeron winning the faceoff, and Char's wrist shot is wide.
Both plays got through to Bergeron, and Bergeron perhaps looking to return the pass. Otherwise had difficulty picking up through a little bit of traffic, but near opportunities. I like that low play in this situation tonight.
The crowd cheering Marty Turco, who is responsible for this Dallas penalty kill. About 45 seconds to go on Boston's power play. Phil Kessel shifting through the neutral zone. Whips it wing to wing. Wheeler picks it up on the carom. Fresh off the bench, it's Axelson. Weidman cocked for a one-timer at the left point.
This is the second time this period Axelson's been on the back end on the power play.
Weidman keeps the puck in the attacking zone. Richards wins it back with a stick check, trying to feed Louis Erickson forward. Erickson follows Axelson to the end boards. Axelson leaves the puck behind. Weidman has to try to rescue it. Only about 15 seconds to go in Boston's power play. Time for one more rush here. Axelson feeds it forward to Kessel. Kessel gains the line, pulls up, throws it into the corner for Wheeler. And Krejci gets there first. Now Wheeler in tandem against Daly. Axelson goes to the bench. And now Neal, who was serving Turco's penalty, is out of the box. Kessel, low for Krejci. Neal gives him a bump. Stewart at the left point. Into the pile, off Boucher's skates. Neal feeds it forward. Erickson can't control. Stewart wrists it around past Turco's reach. 10.5 to go. Trevor Daly. Cross corner dump. McDonald gets there first. Gives the bouncer back. Here we go. Sean Thornton and Chris Bartsch. Two experienced fighters. It's funny how they sent Bartsch out there to settle Ott's disputes. Thornton gets the first shot in. Bartsch tries the uppercut. Thornton measuring him, goes over the top. Bartsch gets rid of the elbow pad. Big right hand from Thornton. Bartsch scores underneath. Thornton under and over and over. Takes and gives, rips the helmet off. Pops him one on the side of the head, pops him another one. Changes and goes lefty. In 1981, the Boston Bruins and Minnesota North Stars combined for 406 penalty minutes.
Well, we won't reach those numbers tonight, Jack, but for those of you that don't mind fighting in a game of hockey, and you've been watching this one from start till right now with 10:29 to go here in the third period, I think you were waiting for this.
Those are the totals for the night right there. Well, you mentioned it before, Brick. Avery was man enough to settle his own dispute. He dropped him, and he went.
Well, I thought Avery had opportunities earlier in the hockey game, certainly with Thornton. Opted not to, and then after the big hit by Ferentz on Ott, then he decided to take on Ferentz in response to that hit.
Ryder trying to get around Ribeiro on the end boards. Back to Chara. The drive tipped and it goes to the corner. Bergeron against Morrow. Low for Ryder. Ribeiro puts on the brakes. Axelsson attacks him. Ryder goes in after it. Ryder lucky not to get a tripping penalty there as he went for the puck with his leg. And Ribeiro went over it. Louis Eriksson wing to wing. Ribeiro picks it up. Works Chara's side of the ice. Throws it across the front and it hits a couple of legs and comes out. David Krejci looks up for transition. 3-on-2 with Ryder and Chara jumping up. Ryder holds the shot. Second chance. Glove save. Turco. He wants transition. Chara with the check and Krejci just trickles it wide. Turco thought he was the third defenseman and he almost ended up giving it away for a 3-goal lead. Chara with a very alert play. And Turco's really hearing it now. Wheeler holds. Sturm going middle. Off to Krejci. Tries to shovel it up. In front for Wheeler. Couldn't turn the backhand. Really opening up now as Dallas has to take chances. Weidman beats Ott to the puck. Wheeler takes the hit to make the play. Yell over the line to Stewart. Scores! Mark Stewart! That's how you get even.
Well, maybe Chris Barge tried to get the momentum turned around for his team when he took on Sean Thornton. Well, it's not going to work. And the Bruins respond beautifully. Steve Ott was way up ice, Jack, looking for a breakaway play. Weidman got in the passing lane. That nullified any kind of rush through center ice. And the Bruins just used the indirect passes off the boards, the good close puck support, short passes, and they activate the defense. Stewart jumps into the play, perfectly timed, takes that feed, and with rotation to the net, a real good wrist shot to give the Bruins their fourth of the night.
Lucic with a big hit on Grossman. Grossman pokes it to Madonna. Richards has Ott on the right side. Ott looking for Madonna. Grossman, big hit. His yell comes out and goes twisting around. Weidman steers the bouncing puck back to Thomas. 8:23 to go in the game. Kessel and Stewart as the Bruins are on a roll of three unanswered goals and a couple of fights won.
Get the sense that this game is over. It's 4-1. Sure, there's plenty of time for another team to score three goals and get back in it, but I think the referee is certainly going to send Steve Ott to the locker room. I'm going to guess a 10-minute misconduct to Steve Ott. I'm not sure if Mark Stewart gets lumped in because of the conversation that was going on.
Well, you know, that's the perfect way for Ott to get out of it. You know, he knows there's 8.5 to go. And if he takes the weakling's coward's way out, he gets a 10-minute misconduct, and he gets sent off. Now Savard goes over, and he's going to trade because he didn't like the cheap shot from, was that Avery at the bottom
Avery.
Of the pile?
It was Avery.
Oh, Niskanen is just getting his kisser rearranged by Sheriff Shane Knighty. Matty Niskanen is not going to be a pretty little boy anymore. Well, you could see this coming in the first period.
Well, I'm not here to beat up referees, Jack, but they've had a hand in this. There are points in this hockey game where they could have made a statement and they didn't. And it's led to this. Avery comes from the blind side, the backside of Milan Lucic, just caves Lucic in along the boards. In comes Mark Savard. And then it's just a 5-on-5. Old-time hockey. Makes me think of that flight home from Calgary watching Slapshot. Well, yeah. There's the hit by Avery.
Yeah.
Here comes Savard, and then it's just almost five black shirts on top of one, and you know Avery's right at the bottom of that pile. And Knighty just taking liberties with Niskanen, who tried to get in there as well. You knew the frustration level was high on both teams, but it has escalated the deeper we've gotten into this hockey game, and this is your end result.
Now, Steve Ott is safely underneath, out of harm's way, protected by cinder block walls and his 10-minute misconduct. He started it, but he wasn't around at the end, was he? The difference is the Hansen brothers were funny. Steve Ott, twice tonight, threw shots at Bruins players' knees. First at Stefan Yell, then at Milan Lucic. The shot on Lucic was 2 seconds after a whistle.
You know, these players have value. Steve Ott, Sean Avery, they're good hockey players. They bring something to the table. They're important to the Dallas Stars and their organization and their success as an organization. But tonight it's been over the line as far as I'm concerned.
Well, they got a lot of bookkeeping to do down below.
And I think the Bruins have handled it perfectly, to be honest with you, Jack. And that's not homerism. It's just a guy that analyzes hockey and observes. And I think the Bruins have done exactly what they've needed to do in order to respond to some of the things that have gone on down at ice level.
When you got your leading scorer coming to the defense of Milan Lucic.
Yeah, enough's enough.
That's a team, as Zdeno Chara said, to Naoko Funayama before. Oh, there's Brave Steve. There he is. Brave Steve in the tunnel. By the way, that's one of the McCorkle brothers, and I would give the edge to the McCorkles. Before the game this morning, Claude Julien was asked about Sean Avery. His response tells you everything you need to know.
You talk to any of the younger guys about just not getting caught up in any on-ice antics with a guy like Avery that's out there, you know?
I really don't want to talk about him, honestly. Next.
This is what was next. Out of all the things that have happened on this 200 by 85 foot sheet tonight, Andrew Ferentz's body check perhaps is the most important punctuation mark, because in that little moment, you can see how the Bruins were able to channel it, as angry as they were, as wronged as they may have been. Ferentz kept it legal. He kept it on the ice. He picked his moment, and it was a devastating clean hit.
Yeah, and I'll cite two examples, Jack. The end result of that, when Avery comes and challenges Ferentz, he drops his gloves, he responds, he answers the bell, something that I don't think the Dallas Stars players that have been involved in all this did. And then this, well, we'll take another look at the hit by Andrew Ferentz. And that led to Avery's response after that great open ice hit. And then the other point I want to make, Jack, is Chris Bartsch now comes on the ice. He's been a non-factor in the hockey game.
Yeah.
A non-factor. And he comes out and he wants to challenge Sean Thornton. And what does Thornton do? He says, all right, I don't have a beef with you.
Right.
You know, it's the other stuff that's going on out here that I'm trying to respond to. But if it means I got to take on you, I'll do it. And I'll do it well. Those two incidences right there in themselves tell me the Bruins have handled this perfectly tonight.
That's because Sean Thornton is the kind of guy that you would like your son to turn out to be. And he will stand by his teammates and he will do what is right.
And two things here. This kind of game breeds unity, as far as I'm concerned, as far as where the Bruins' perspective is. And I don't think that needs a whole lot of a jump start anyway, because this is a good group and they all pull for each other and they believe in each other. But it continues to build unity. And the second thing it does to it, it just goes to how difficult the Bruins will be to play here at home if they're going to play like this and win hockey games.
Absolutely. Very important statement in this game, not only with the score, but the style. And as Zdeno Chara told Naoko Funayama before tonight's game, that what he likes best about this team is its unity and how the guys fight for each other. And they have built on the stability that they established last year. Ribeiro and Chara mucking down on the boards.
And keep playing the game. He's still got about 7.5 minutes to go. Don't play the score. Continue to play the game. The score will, it'll change some of the decisions that you make in order to protect the lead, but continue to play the game and play it hard.
The captains, Morrow and Chara, in the corner. Ribeiro backing toward the left wing corner. Morrow looking for a feed in front. Krejci picks his pocket. Morrow's going to the box. Chara gets the outlet. Ward tries to kick it over to Sturm in the neutral zone. And the penalty is called to Brendan Morrow.
We haven't had a chance to talk Morrow a lot tonight, but he is a quality player, Jack. And one of the notes about him was last year, the only player in the NHL to have 70-plus points in over 100 penalty minutes. So he's involved. He's a good offensive force. He does everything hard. He's a good leader. He takes penalties, but majority of the time they're good penalties. They're tough penalties. They're hard penalties. But he'll go to the box for another offensive zone penalty tonight for Dave Tippett's club. And again, it's just frustration at this point.
But something you said between periods off camera and off mic.
Don't get me in trouble.
That a professional hockey player does not mind getting knocked down if it's shoulder to shoulder. That's the kind of hit that Brendan Morrow,
correct.
You know, it's dangerous to paint with a broad brush, and Dallas has done a lot of despicable things tonight, but not that guy. Number 10 is a good, clean, hard-nosed player. Robidoux, same kind of mold. You know, they're gonna hit you, they're going face-to-face with you. They're not backing into your knees. Krejci wins the faceoff. The power play underway. Phil Kessel cross ice. Krejci looking for Wheeler in front. Wheeler's picked up his first two NHL assists tonight. Weidman fans on the shot. Good stick check. Toby Peterson has a partial break. Ferris trying to limit his space. Peterson takes all the way behind the goal.
Great angle by Ferentz. Good skating ability. You know he has that, but he took the perfect angle and didn't allow Peterson any kind of opportunity, certainly not to cut back to the forehand.
Kessel hard across the blue line, and Wheeler takes it on the carom, tries to slip it through to Krejci, bouncing around. Modano chops it out of the slot. Peterson tees it up and wraps it in around behind Thomas. Well, the tenor of play has done my throat pulled a heck of a lot of good tonight, huh? Chara kicking the puck loose, but Richard scrapes it all the way down the board.
You know, we talked about what teams are going to be there at the end of the season. You know, a couple of games ago in the pregame show, I talked about Dallas because of their organization, because of their coaching, because of their talent level. I just expect them to be there. Playoff team out west every year, year in and year out. It's what I expect. And you know, it's not that you're not a fan of these guys. It's just a couple of players.
Sturm puts a bow on it. Tick-tock goal.
Well, Marco Sturm started the scoring tonight for the Bruins. He may have just ended it. Nice little triangle setup offense. Bruins free up the puck behind the net. Ryda ends up with it. Finds Axelsson in that high slot area. Turco's expecting shot. He comes out to challenge. Axelsson very cleverly just slides it off the side of the net to a waiting Marco Sturm, who positioned himself beautifully. You got to get to those spots if you're going to be goal scorers. Even though they're layup goals, Jack, you have to know how to be there, when to be there with timing. Good pass Ryder, good pass Axelsson.
I believe this is the Bruins' biggest lead of the season.
Just to finish that thought, though, Jack, I'm talking about two guys here tonight that really have been problematic for us, you know, and for everybody else. You don't want to talk. You talked about painting people or players with a, you know, wide brush. I'm talking about the entire Dallas team. It's really been two guys that have had the focus of this Bruins club.
Peterson's shot. Yell blocks it down. Tries to spring Kessel. Weidman goes cross ice. Ferentz. Pass deflects to the corner. Nokalainen and Romanov. Grossman lugs it out of his own zone. Wheeler deflects the pass and it goes into the Boston bench. 4:48 to go in the game. The Bruins are putting the hurt to the Dallas Stars. 5-1 at TD Bank North Garden. The Bruins have scored 5 goals on 24 shots. Tim Thomas has allowed just 1 on 36. Thomas went 21 for 21 in the second period. Crowd's having fun right now. Sturm with a good stick check. Krejci off the boards into Robidas' corner. Sturm hops around Robidas. Wheeler trying to feed it in front off Richards' skates. Back to Chara. Chara's blast rockets high off glass. And the faceoff is going to go all the way back down to the Bruins' end of the ice. No, outside the line. I'm sorry, the initial I mistook the initial signal. Weidman risks the puck off glass. Weidman keeps it in as Turco tried to clear it himself. Bergeron spins Daly, turns him to the backhand. Weidman over to Ferentz. Ferentz the drive. Knocked down in front. Axelsson can't scoop the rebound in. Less than 4 minutes to go in this game, and the Bruins still showing a great deal of hunger, and Dallas not showing a lot of fight left.
Well, it's important that you continue good habits. This game very comfortably over. 4-goal lead under 4 minutes to go in regulation. You don't want to get in any bad habits, and you want to continue all good habits right to the final buzzer.
A bit of a ribald Saturday night cheer from the crowd. Trying to rub a little salt in the wounds of the Dallas Stars, who lost 5-2 in Chicago last night and are on the receiving end of a 5-1 beating by the Bruins tonight in Boston. Morrow tips the puck into the corner. Morrow ties up Ferentz. Erickson against Nokalainen. Nokalainen. More jump in his legs. Dumps it down into the corner as Boucher comes over to administer the hit. Thornton bangs Erickson. Daly leaves it for Boucher. About 3 minutes to go. Well, Rick, one of the Bruins' missions coming in off the road after going 4-2-2 on the road in October was to make TD Bank North Garden a very difficult place to play and a place that teams do not want to enter. Not a bad statement to start things out. Ward's shot tipped through the middle, and Turco makes a splendid save with 2:40 to go.
The Bruins are offering $19 tickets for select games to kids participating in hockey programs. The next Youth Hockey Night is Saturday, November 8th. For tickets or more information, visit bostonbruins.com or call 617-624-BEAR.
Is tonight the night we turn back the clocks?
I think we did just watching this game.
Exactly. That's where I was going.
That's where I thought you were going.
How's that for synergy?
I don't know if I should finish your thought for you.
That's fine. Bergeron against Grossman. Richards comes in to help out against the end boards. Bergeron scoots the puck away from Richards, but Robidoux wants a breakout. Brunstrom rips it in around behind Thomas. Chara has a lot of space. Cross ice off Kessel's skates. The arm is up for icing. And the faceoff comes back to Tim Thomas's end of the ice. Bruins Overtime Live is coming up next on Nesson. Tim Thomas will be the Garden studio guest of Catherine Tappan and Barry Peterson. Thomas has equaled a season high with 35 saves tonight. Chara up the wall, off Axelson's skates. Axelson tips it past Boucher, and the Bruins change up. Less than 2 minutes to go. Goals tonight. Sturm beginning and ending the Boston scoring. Bergeron, Kessel, and Stewart in between after Avery had tied the game 1-1.
Yeah, it'd be nice to see Tim Thomas after the game in the studio. And you know, he come into tonight with just impressive numbers, a save percentage of 939, the goals against under two. And those numbers at this point will only improve.
Losing only a 3-2 game at Calgary. Calgary, by the way, had extended its winning streak to 5 with that. I got a feeling Tim Thomas is going to be the NHL player of the week. I'm way out there with speculation all the time, but that's my guess. Toby Peterson kicks it ahead of his own reach. Ferentz to Weidman. How good has Andrew Ferentz been this season?
Yeah, I know we had three players on our text question, and it's difficult to narrow it down to three because a number of guys had been real good. I don't think anybody would supplant Thomas even if he had the whole roster to choose from, but Andrew Ferentz certainly would have gotten his share of votes.
The crowd giving the Bruins a robust round of applause. Many are on their feet at TD Bank North Garden. Grossman, Morrow just wide on the glove side. Chara in the corner. Gets back to his skates. Off to Weidman. Indirect for Thornton. Touch pass for Krejci in the middle. Trying to hit Sturm in a seam against Boucher. They joust. Krejci on the far side spins away from Erickson. Wheeler going to the middle, and Wheeler can't quite find the handle. But boy, he found the seam, and Krejci found him with the pass. Final 30 seconds. Sturm flails at it while paying the price. Sturm out on the ice with a chance to get a hat trick after being in a goal-scoring slump. Claude Julien wanted more from him. He got it tonight. 10 seconds to go. Rivera lugs it over the red line. Wild wide on the stick side. Listen to the crowd at TD Bank North Garden. You had 11 seasons in the NHL, Brick. What does a win like this at home feel like?
Rewarding, I guess, is the simplest way I could put it. All the hard work that you expended on the road trip in order to get 4 of a possible 6. You had one bad period against Calgary. Otherwise, you had a chance of running the table. But it becomes meaningless unless you come home and play the way the Bruins played tonight. I know they gave up 21 shots in the second period, but I liked everything about this one tonight as far as the Bruins are concerned.